Hi, this is Shadi, and today we will discuss judo's ground game, its birth, where it comes from, who is the particular father, which jiu-jitsu school, how it came to be, particularly the basic position, up until how it became this very crafted system, like you see here in front of you, really taking the time on the ground and doing these long sessions of randori. Before that, jiu-jitsu was a very self-defense oriented schools, and thus no such thing or barely anything existed at the time for ground game, barely like the positions just to pin, but everything else was done in the stand-up. Like I said, today it's going to be going through jiu-jitsu, Gosen Judo, how it all came to be, because I've been doing this for a little over a year and a half now, and with rigorous finding out, exploration and research, now I believe that we have a much more clear image of what happened. It isn't just as simple as judo. It's just you throw and then whatever is available, you take advantage of it. It is far more complex than that. Even in the new IJF judo, I believe I did an analysis showing all the fundamentals still being very much used, like sweeping, guard passing, playing guard, etc. So first, let's start with the jiu-jitsu fatherhood. Jigoro Kano studied Tenjin Shinryu Jiu-Jitsu, and there is enough evidence to show that the bulk of Neiwaza of judo came from the Tenjin Shinryu. Here you see the guard slash do jime being applied here in the scrolls, I believe circa 1820s or 1830s. Here you see the armbar again being applied, like the most two popular things to be applied on the ground, which is the guard and the arm bars. Here you see them from the Tenjin Shinryu Jiu-Jitsu. Here we are starting to create a clear image. Now here you see Jigoro Kano himself applying the Juji Getame himself from the old school of his Jiu-Jitsu, and thus it made its way to Judo. Here more positions, you have the mount. Here you see like you have one foot is in the front and one is in the back to maintain and really control the mount, and here like grabbing the lapel, I believe like trying to apply a tsukomi jime. Here you see like one is in the back, one is in the front, kind of like an S mount. Here you see both two variations of the side control. One is applying a katate jime, one is trying to grab the arm and really trying to pin down the shoulder. Again, you are starting to see like the basic variations of the pins or the osaikomi. The first one here, you are seeing like grabbing the lapel and pushing the forearm downwards. You can see this is called a katate jime. Here you see passing guard and then applying the choke, katate jime. Here you see the rear naked choke, again from the Tenjin Shinryu Jiu-Jitsu scrolls, arguably the most famous choke even in BJJ, like whatever level it may be, this choke is the king. Taking the back is still till this day king. More positions here, you see a side control, applying it, really controlling the hakama from the side, from below, and controlling the shoulder via the lapel and applying pressure with the stomach on the stomach. Again, like here you see you are trying to see your basic positions, but again, Tenjin Shinryu did not have these like long sessions of neiwaza really rolling, because it is far more self-defense oriented in the stand-up, as you see in the old kata. Here you see what is called the 100 kilo position. Here you see Kano applying a okuri eri jime, again coming from the old Tenjin Shinryu. I believe I've showed this in my judo chokes jujutsu roots, something like that. Here you see it, you grab the collar and with the other you pull down, and then with the other you push pull push pull. Now when neiwaza really took its like was put on overdrive was because of this rivalry. Tanabe was tapping out Kodokan judokas, and Isogai wanted to put an end of his horror streak basically, and they had their rivalry from 1899 till 1900, three matches until he was basically dominated. So this is where they really started to take their time on the ground and training for hours on end. Particularly Isogai and Kaichiro Samura really pushed neiwaza. Here you see Yukio Tani and Gojiko Izumi Kodokan, Judoka, and Budokai in the 1910s. You are seeing here, I know it looks very basic, but for their time, you know, maintaining guard retention, trying to pass open guard, applying submissions, really shows that the ground game is really becoming more popular. Here you see a Kimura before Kimura was born, or he was 1 year old. So the claim that it came by Kimura through catch wrestling, in my opinion, is false. Here you are seeing a lot more demonstrations on the ground. Here you see like a cross choke from the back, a rear naked choke. So here in the 1910s is where ground game really took its popularity and people starting to train it more, particularly with Hajime Isogai. You see, in the 1910s, Kyoto became far more distinguished from the Tokyo branch of the Kodokan, and they were starting to do more Neiwaza. Even so, that they would all they would do is actually Neiwaza, and here you are seeing a demonstration of guard passing. So what happened was, in Kyoto, they really started to apply all but Neiwaza because they believe that the youth have far more endurance, and they at the same time it would train them to be far more strategical. I talked about this in a video called the Genesis of Kosen Judo and why they would prefer the ground far more, and also I believe I did a video called Oda versus Kano, and I talked about the 1918 incident where they had their like back and forth, where Oda wanted to do all Neiwaza because it brought all the trophies home, while Kano wanted to keep it more of a realistic self-defense where you start in the standing and truly like ending things on the ground. So Tsunetane Oda, in my opinion, here you see him doing like these Toriando passes, all these very revolutionary things from the 1910s, 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s. It's where he truly shined and showed things like De La Hiva guard, Toriando passes, like these cartwheel passes. You see this footage actually 30 minutes long, and there's just all much of gems. You see, even like till this day in the high level IBJJF competitions. So Tsunetane Oda really made Neiwaza something absolutely marvelous, crafted it, escapes, passes, not just the basic positions you saw from the Tenjin Shinryu Jujutsu. And in 1918, he had like a back and forth with Kano because all his students were doing nothing but Neiwaza, and Kano did not like that because he didn't want guard pulls. He wanted to keep it a real form of fighting and also education, while Oda, all he thought about was the sports aspect, and he thought that Neiwaza was like the best and it would bring all the trophies home, but that doesn't mean it's the best for self-defense, according to Kano. And I do agree with Kano, because you have to keep your cool in the stand-up as well. You cannot be pulling guard and doing berimbolos like Mitsuro Kimura and all these people. People knock the turtle all the time, saying, you know, you get soccer kicked, and I agree, but at the same time there is a lot of unrealistic aspects of the ground game itself, like berimbolos, 50-50, and guard pulling itself. Like for self-defense, it's just not like the same. Here you see crafting the seat belt, doing like the figure four back, etc. So really it's what like took its height. It's with Tsunetane Oda here. But after the loss of World War II, the Kyoto branch really died out because of its ties with the Dai Nippon Butoku Kai, and that had its ties with the imperial regime that lost the war. So Neiwaza there really took a big hit. It did not die off, but it certainly was not as popular, and it became all the Tokyo style of judo. And at the same time, there was this like big endeavors to really put judo on the in the Olympics, and they finally did that in 1964. So after that, they could not really keep it like the Neiwaza. It did not die off. Kosen judo is still a thing in the seven imperial universities of Japan, as you see here in front of you. But everything else, like today, Neiwaza is still very much existent, but it is far more a dynamic thing. It is not the end all be all like BJJ. It is part of a very dynamic game. This is essentially the story of Neiwaza, of judo, the guards, etc. All these like are thanks to this man, like Tsunetane Oda, but the game has to reflect a little bit more of a self-defense, in my opinion. Like Kano wanted it far more dynamic, far more explosive, agile, and Neiwaza should stay a part of this, not just these long sequences. Unless that would be BJJ, which is a very respectable art, like I said, like the Tsunetane Oda type of judo, which was called Tsunetane Ryu. That's how much it was distinct from the Kodokan judo. They wanted to be another thing, a jujitsu school of its own called Tsunetane Ryu. So if you have anything else to add, please let me know down below. Also, consider supporting me on Patreon. I have exclusive content for the patrons only. And please do not forget to check out Josh Simon's website and shop. Link will be in the description. This was Shadi, and thank you for listening.